Hello YouTube video people. I'm in my shop again today. I wanted to show you two of the pieces of equipment that I have. This one will be leaving at some particular time because I really outgrew it. It just wasn't capable of doing what the new Grizzly Geo555X Extreme could do, and it just made life a whole lot easier to do some of the things that I needed to do, such as cut radiuses and banks. And I have the extension kit for this, but I have not put the extension kit on it yet, but I do plan on doing that in time. I made a mistake and I bought a few of the blades that were 93.5 inches long. And when I got the rising block, then it said that you needed 105. So I ordered one of those blades when I purchased the saw. It's a great saw. It does so much more than this particular saw does. The cutting capacity of this saw here is just very limited. I make banks, with post office box fronts on them, and you can't get them underneath this saw where you can with the Grizzly. You just have so much more room, and for resawing as well. I also make jewelry boxes and things like that where I need to cut these things in half or down the middle, and I have resaw capabilities with this particular unit where I do not with the Craftsman. The Craftsman has been a great saw. I just tuned it up. I've put new blades in it and gone through it very carefully and lubed everything. And I put it on Craigslist, but it still hasn't sold yet. But it's a great little saw. It's a great little saw. You really cannot beat this one. I have looked at some of the newer ones, and they're not built as good as this particular one is. The Grizzly is also very heavily built. I like it really a lot. It's very smooth. This one, even though that it's a good saw, it's not as smooth as the Grizzly. The Grizzly is so much better in that aspect. And I do have the rising block for it, and I am going to change this from a 6 to a 12 sometime down the road. I'm not just sure just when, but I am going to do it. But for right now, it does what I want it to do with just the area of the cutting area that it has right now. And it's very smooth and it's so much nicer. I made this stand for this particular saw so I can move it around. Everything in the shop has to be mobile. I just have a double car garage here. So a lot of times, I move things outside the garage, I can do certain projects. Because my garage is actually heated, it has a wood stove just to my right here, and the garage door is just to the left, and it just needs to be, everything just needs to be mobile. Most everything in the shop is mobile. Most everything. There are a few pieces that are not mobile that are in the shop, that cannot be moved. But I'm learning to make certain sacrifices and stuff like that. I have sold a lot of equipment that I've never really used. Some of it was my father's, some of it was my own, that I was accumulating over the years, and it just did not work for me anymore. I had a radio alarm saw that was my father's, and I had a shopsmith, which was mine. But the shopsmith, even though that it did a lot of different things, it took so long to set everything up on the thing. You know, first you were going to saw with it, and then you wanted to use it as a drill press, and it just took too long of a time to do that with. Later on, I'm going to show you how I build some of the things that I do. I'm going to show you how to build the post office box bank, how I go about doing this. It's not too hard. I get a lot of the stuff from Rockler, and I buy different types of various woods and stuff like that. And the music boxes are, mitered edges, and they're all glued together. And then I use the resaw capability of the Grizzly in order to get them in half so I can put the hinges on them. But anyway, I wanted to just say that, these are both wonderful saws, and so is the Craftsman. But I'm going, I've had to learn to just let go of certain things, and when I replaced the Craftsman with this one, it's because I wanted something a little bit bigger. This one, by the way, is still working. It's still a great saw. You can't really beat it, but it's very limited to what it can do, not compared to the Grizzly Extreme that is right here that I have been using now for a little over a month. And you'll never find, it is really smooth. Most of the saws that are out there right now are the small, for just the weekend woodworker and everything, they're pretty small and they're pretty compact, and they're not really built as good as these two saws are. And I wanted something that was going to last for a while. So anyway, I just wanted to tell you that this Grizzly bandsaw is really, really good. I'm going to try to get this one back on Craigslist again and see if I can get it sold. I have a bunch of blades for it, brand new blades. I built the stand for it. I've rewired it. I've gone through it, tuned it up, and everything. It's just a beautiful saw, but it's very limited. So anyway, I want to thank you, viewers that view my channel. Pop in from time to time. I put out videos just as fast as I can make them. Sometimes my day doesn't allow me to make videos. But if you would hit the comments at the bottom of the page and subscribe, then you won't miss when I put out a new video. Thank you very much. Goodbye.